Hi, this is Dr. A with your medical terminology video on body organization, and we are going to look at the levels of organization. So the body is organized into levels. The smallest level is the cell, at the cell level, cellular level. Then cells are grouped into tissues. Tissues are grouped into organs. Organs are grouped into organ systems, and then organ systems together make up the body. Another way to look at it is each level is built from the one below it. So we could go the other way around and go the body as a whole is made of organ systems. Organ systems are composed of organs. The organs are composed of tissues, and the tissue is composed of cells. So let's start with the cells. The root word is cyte, combining form cyto, as in cytology, the study of cells. Macrocyte, a large cell. Microcyte, a small cell. Erythrocyte, a red cell, or leukocyte, a white cell. The cell is a fundamental unit of life, so everything that's happening in your body is happening because it's happening at the cellular level. The cell has all the properties of being alive, as in it can respond to stimuli, it engages in metabolic activity, and it reproduces itself. All tissues and organs in the body are formed of cells. Cells do come in different sizes and shape, as illustrated here in the picture. Some are long, some of your muscle cells are as long as the muscle in your body, so it can be the length of your thigh muscle, for example, and some are really small. And the one thing they have in common is that all cells at some point in their life cycle have a nucleus, a cytoplasm, and cell membrane. Next is tissue. So histo is the combining form. Hist is the root word, forming histology, the study of tissue. And tissues are formed when like cells are grouped together to perform an activity. There are four major types of tissue. There is muscle tissue. So we would think they're a skeletal muscle that does movement, but cardiac muscle that moves blood in our system. And a smooth muscle that can move things or like lining organs and things like that. So it can move food, for example, through our digestive system. Next is the epithelial tissue. So epithelial tissue lines stuff. They're little linings. So they're your skin. It's your skin. The inside, they're lined like your mucous membrane. It lines all of that. It lines all your body cavities. And it's usually in direct contact with the outside or the inside. It depends on where it's located. Next, we have the connective tissue. So connective tissue in general connects stuff, binds stuff together. So the example usually used is tendons and ligaments. Tendons connecting muscles to bone, ligaments connecting bones to bones, but also you have cartilage, and then you have some other connective tissues that kind of hold certain things together. Connective tissue is what gives liver its shape and spleen its shape. So that's the connect stuff, that's connective tissue. And then nervous tissue is the nervous system, neurons and stuff. Its primary function then is to control, sense and control the body and the organs and tissue, etc. So nervous tissue, if you will, kind of relays information. The organs are composed of several types of tissue assembled together that work together as a unit to perform special functions. For example, the stomach contains muscle fibers, nerve tissues, and epithelial tissue, and all together these work to secrete the digestive juices, the stomach acid that starts breaking down the food that we have swallowed and that has entered our stomach. And then the organ systems are composed of several organs that work together in a coordinated manner, and together they perform more complex functions. So if we go back to our example with the stomach, so yes, the stomach starts the digestive process. Well, actually the mouth starts the digestive process, but the stomach is starting to break down of the food that has been swallowed with the stomach acid, but it has to work with, well, the mouth, first of all, to chew the food and swallow it, the esophagus to conduct the food down and to the stomach, but then it also needs to work with the liver that makes bile, the pancreas that makes all the pancreatic secretions and the enzymes, and the small intestines that help keep breaking it down and start absorbing it, and then the colon to gather up all the waste and get rid of it. And all together, then they have the function of breaking the food down, digesting it, and absorbing it, and then eliminating the waste, of course, that is produced. So, and then if you take all the organ systems together, they form a body, a person. And so we're going to look at each individual organ system in the next video.